Om Namo Bhagavate Sri Aranachala Ramanaya. In the first series of verses of videos today, the first topic I'm going to talk about is about ego. These are several, each of these videos will be a question that I has been asked at some point in my on my YouTube channel, in the comments on my YouTube channel. So I will answer several of these questions today. The first question is, who is aware of I am? If it's ego that will be aware of I am, then I am, i.e. the self, will become an object for the ego. Still getting confused with who does the practice of investigation. Who is aware of I am? It's not a matter of being aware of I am. It's a matter of being aware I am. I am is not an object of awareness. What is aware I am is I. That is, we ourselves are aware of our own existence. I am means I exist. So who knows I exist? I know I exist. So what is aware I am is ourself. Our real nature is pure awareness. It is aware of nothing other than itself, nothing other than its own existence. As ego, we are aware of our existence, and we are also aware of an identity. We are not just aware of ourselves as I am, we are aware of ourselves as I am this person. I am Rene, I am Michael, I am whoever. So this ego is the adjunct mixed awareness I am. It's not that there are two I's, I is only one. But when I is in its pure condition, that is our real nature, that is what we actually are. When it is seemingly mixed and conflated with adjuncts, the resulting conflation or mixture is what is called ego. So our real nature, of course, that is, our real nature means ourselves as we actually are. So as we actually are, we are always aware of our own existence as I am. As ego also, we're aware of our existence, I am. But in addition to being aware of our existence, we're also aware of an identity. I am this or I am that. I am this body. So as ego, we are aware that but we are wrongly aware of what we are. We mistake ourselves to be something other than what we actually are. So the aim of self-investigation is to know ourselves as we actually are. So long as we are aware of anything other than ourselves, we who are aware of other things are ego. That is, it's only when we are identified with the body that we are aware of other things. So awareness of other things occurs only to ourselves as ego, only to that adjunct mixed awareness, I am. So in order to be aware of ourselves as we actually are, we need to cease being aware of other things by attending only to I am. The more we attend to I am, that is to our own being, our own existence, the more aware our attention will be withdrawn from other things. So other things will withdraw into the background of our awareness, so to speak, and I am will be more and more center of our field of awareness, our attention. As we go deeper and deeper within by attending to I am, to our own existence, to ourself, other things withdraw more and more, and eventually we become aware of ourself alone. When we're aware of nothing other than I am, nothing other than our own existence, that is the state of pure awareness. As soon as we experience ourselves as pure awareness, the false awareness, called ego, will thereby be destroyed. That is, when we're aware of ourselves as we actually are, we can no longer be aware, we mistake ourselves to be anything other than that. So this is how the destruction of ego is achieved by self-investigation. So coming back to these questions, the first question, who is aware of I am? Well, rather than saying who is aware of I am, it's better to say who is aware I am. Who is aware I am? I am aware I am. So it's not another thing that is aware I am. I alone am aware I am. And then the question goes on, if it's ego that is aware of I am, then I am, i.e. the self, will become an object for ego. No. When we're aware I is obviously not an object. What is aware of I is only I. I am is simply a statement, but that is the words I am, they're a statement of our existence. I exist. So what the words I am refer to are our existence. Our existence can never be an object of awareness. Existence and awareness are one and the same. Sat is chit and chit is sat. So our own, what we actually are is pure awareness. So pure awareness is our very existence. We have no existence independent of pure awareness. So our existence and our awareness are one. So I am is never an object of awareness, just like ego is never an object of awareness. We can never know ourselves as an object. Ego is the subject. I am is the reality underlying the subject. What appears as the subject is only I am. But I am is not the subject. The subject is I am. Just like the rope is not a snake, but the snake is a rope. The rope, what seems to be a snake, is nothing but a rope. But the rope is never a snake. Likewise, our real nature, what we actually are, the pure awareness, is never ego. But ego is never anything other than pure awareness. So coming back to the question, so it's just because we're aware I am doesn't mean I am is an object of our awareness. We are aware of ourself, our own existence as I am. And then the person says, still getting confused with who does the practice of investigation. The practice of investigation is done only by ourself as ego. As we actually are, we don't need to investigate ourselves because we are clearly aware of ourselves as we actually are. But as ego, we're aware of ourselves now as something other than what we actually are. We take ourselves to be this body and mind. So the problem is for ego. Therefore, it is ego that needs to investigate. It's ourself as ego who need to investigate ourselves and thereby know ourselves as we actually are. So by turning our attention within, we as ego are attending to ourself. But ego, as I said, is an adjunct conflated awareness. It's that which is aware of itself as I am this body. So, but though ego is this mixture of the pure awareness I am and the adjuncts with which it is conflated, when we're investigating ourselves, we're not investigating the adjuncts. We're not investigating this body or mind or anything else that we take ourselves to be. We're investigating ourselves. That means we're investigating our own existence. That is what I am is referring to, our own existence. So it is ego investigating itself, or to put it more precisely, it is ego, it is ourself as ego, investigating our own reality, investigating what we actually are. What we actually are is just the pure awareness I am. I hope this is a clear answer to that question. Om Namo Bhagavate Sri Arunachala Ramanaya.